Ladies and gents, welcome to the Gaming Apocalypse. I'm Wraith, and this is Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. Before we hop in, remember, you are an awesome person, so keep being awesome to others, okay? Alright, let's jump in and do this. That's a really big statue over there. This feels really different for some reason. Give me just a second. I think I need to do a quick adjustment. There we go. Field of view is still a little screwy, so. Okay. Got ourselves a defender out here. What you got for me, huh? Thank you for that. There we go. That was the timing I needed. Alright, buddy.
Why suffer the past when there is a new road ahead? The only one that makes any sense.
Ah. Okay, interesting. So I can use the focus meter to basically slow time. Another thing I wish this game had told me before. In on him. There we go. Okay, so the little glowy disc thing. Apparently, if I hit the focus button, that allows me to, like, stop time, or at least stop the enemies for a second or two. Another thing I wish they had told me about. But this game really doesn't hold your hand at all. Which is a good thing. It's nice to be able to explore this stuff. Ow. You're a big one. Alright, didn't move fast enough for that. Oh. Okay. She won't make it. Wow. Okay, this guy is... All right, Biggin. What's your deal here? Thank you. Okay. Ooh, okay. How the heck you recovered from that, I don't know. Ooh, okay. Big boy's down. That's good news. Nope. Come on, come on, come on. Get me up, get me up, get me up. Unleash. Go into bloodlust mode. Didn't read the timing on that correctly for that melee attack. Okay. Found a new enemy type. And he's a very, very, very big, unhappy boy. So we just had an interesting issue with the game deciding to crap out. So we're having to pick up a little bit here, which means I'll have to redo the little puzzle quest. It's not hard. Doesn't take long to do. There we go. Get the three things that I need to find. Come out here.
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path. Align yourself.
All right, I guess we'll try to stitch this. Hopefully there's enough of the other video file that I can stitch everything together and it won't be completely foobar. Because unfortunately... No, it was over here. Come over here and look up, and you've got the X right there. Golden. Then we got the little Space Invader symbol and the S symbol. So if we run across here... There we go. There's your S symbol. And then little Space Invader guy is around this corner and up the ladder. Go. If not, well, this will be an interesting game, I guess. An interesting recording, that is. All right, we're out. on a partially completed bridge. Well, I guess the bridge itself was completed at some point. It just is kind of falling apart now.
The gate is opening.
If I had to guess, it's because somebody's coming out to say hello.
It's coming. That song again.
The giantess?
Yes, the source of the darkness. It's coming. This is your moment.
I'm sorry. I can't watch this.
What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior. You're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
Stormy seas and lost soul.
Interesting.
She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what Hell is? World shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be?
So stupid.
Everyone hates her. She's a curse.
The shadow.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there is no one left to do that for you. Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just like your sword.
Come on. Why go on when you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined? Why go on?
Oh, was she cauterizing a wound on her head?
Ask this, or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling. Song. It's real. It's trick. It's not real. Listen to it.
She can't give up.
Did it?
Not like this.
It's not real. It's real. It's a trick. Don't trust it. Maybe you're already dead.
Who are you?
You stop believing me, Shadow. Come to me. Please.
Interesting. Also, that's a heck of a fall. Assuming that's where we got yeeted off that bridge at. And do we actually not have... Yeah, we... Sword was actually broken. So if we run into any more of these little defender things, we're gonna be in for a world of hurt. Because we can't exactly defend ourselves without a sword. What exactly am I going towards? Other than what looks like a good fall.
Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely.
Away.
Eyes. He moved as if dancing. And the world danced with him. The gloom lifted. And for the first time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
What was over here? Got a runic lock on it of some kind. But it's complex enough that I can't seem to figure it out. Or it's just I'm not at the point in the story where it's ready for me to find this. Maybe.
His name is Signar. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
Huh. Sounds like they're not great people. But I guess that's the downside to envy. Not that there's really an upside to it, but, you know. Alright, so there was a locked door back there. A bunch of runes on it. I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to be looking for out here. Oh, wait a minute. That little story time, does that mean that I'm gonna end up finding the Sword of Odin? That Sigmund was able to retrieve? Because that'd be pretty cool if I could.
Day after day, watching from afar, she mimicked him, perfecting her own secret.
Sigmund and his brother seem certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in a forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
So this is offering a reality that, as though nothing ever actually happened.
The world and bliss. If only she could do the same. See the world through eyes anew. And dance with it. Just like he does.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not. I don't leave home much.
Oh. Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you. And
you learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillian. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you. Make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, and don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel it.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No!
And all your suffering will have been for nothing!
Shut up! Dillion? Is that you? I'll find you, man. I promise.
Huh. This game goes kind of wild. I'm still not 100% sure what to think of it, or what I just saw. But it's definitely getting more and more interesting as it goes. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and end the episode here. As it is, I'm going to have to try to stitch two clips together and hope and pray that it doesn't, you know, completely... Like, it's not super noticeable because the game decided to crash halfway through the recording. So we're going to have to figure out how to stitch the two together and make them somewhat usable. Anyways, so we're going to go ahead and end the episode here. If you enjoyed the video, please do give it a thumbs up. Help keep the YouTube overlords happy. And if you want to make sure you don't miss out on whatever crazy stuff is going to happen in the next episode, I don't know where this game is going. But if you want to come along for the ride, well, hit the subscribe button. And make sure that you use the notification bell, that way you know whenever I post a new video. Until next time, thank you very much for watching. Hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. And remember that life does get rough sometimes, so good luck, have fun, stay awesome. Catch you in the next one.